So today we'll be looking very briefly at the guarded suspension design pattern. So according to this design pattern, let's assume there is a class A and there is a guarded method which is synchronized. So this is a synchronized method, hence as you know that out of two synchronized methods, only one can be called at a time on an object by multiple threads. Okay, so if there are suppose two threads and they are operating on the same object, then they can call at most one synchronized method at a time. So let's say this has been called, then this cannot be called, this has to wait until this finishes. Unless you explicitly ask this thread to wait, this method to wait. So if you write wait, then you are releasing your lock. So you are releasing your lock and you are giving chance to this method to run. So on the same object, this method can be called if I am in a wait mode. So wait means releasing the lock and sleeping for some time. What is the some time? Till someone else notifies me. So this alter object method will change the state and notify this method, so that this method can proceed to the actual method implementation. So this method will wait till this precondition is true. So hence it is guarded by this precondition. So first thing is, the thread cannot enter in this method if any other synchronized method has already been called on that object, because at most one synchronized method can be called on that object, on any object at a time. Okay, so hence the actual method implementation is locked, because unless you acquire the lock, you cannot reach it. And at most one thread can have the lock for an object at a time. So first thing is, actual method implementation is protected by a lock. Other thing is, it is protected by a guard, which is the precondition. So whenever we alter stage, alter the object state, we change the object state and we again notify. So it will again check whether this precondition is true or false. If it is still false, then it will again, not of false is true, then it will again go and wait. So it will wait till the precondition is false. As soon as the precondition becomes true, it will go out of this while loop and proceed with the actual method implementation. So this is protected by a lock and by a guard. So this is the guarded suspension design pattern. Hope you understood. Thank you, friends.